Good evening, board members. My name is Candace Lucas. I'm a parent in Henrico County. I'm also an advocate for equity in schools, a national organization that is a member organization of Dignity in Schools, which consists of over 100 organizations. I have to give a shout out to my white brothers and sisters that came up here to talk about Byrd High School and changing the name. But I've been coming to Henrico County School Board meetings since 2007, been coming here longer than most of these board members. And in our opinion, as African-American people, people of color in general that have attended school, taught in school, and live in this community, it doesn't matter if you remove Harry Byrd's name, and there were references, massive resistance, if you continue to cultivate the culture of massive resistance that we live with today. In the years that I've been coming before this board, I have continually addressed the issue of the disproportionate racial issues that are going on in this county. When me as an African-American woman is banned from the schools because I advocate for black children and you guys don't like it, that's a Harry Byrd tactic, a Jim Crow tactic, that's a complete massive resistance tactic. When Henrico County is number 3 in the nation for violating the civil rights of black boys, that sounds like Harry Byrd to me, does it not? When a child, an African-American female at Verona High School can be told how dirty and how insensitive and how her life doesn't matter, Dr. Kinlaw, by Mr. Rinaldi, a substitute teacher, a white male, and nothing be done about it, that sounds like Harry Byrd to me. So when we talk about Harry Byrd being in the past, massive resistance being in the past, we talk about Jim Crow being in the past, in Henrico County, massive resistance is alive and well to those of us that live with it every day. And I appreciate the white people that are using their white privilege to get this point across, but there are those of us who live every day with the massive resistance that goes on in Henrico County. Our children do not have the same equity regarding resources. I taught in Henrico's East End. I had to go to the West End to get books that were still in shrink wrap in the storage room. I know these things. And because I spoke out, you all know, I was terminated. Because I decided to advocate for children that were of color, I was removed. My contract was not renewed. That sounds Harry Byrdish to me. That sounds massive resistance to me. That's what it sounds like. So before we decide that we're gonna go ahead and change the name, we need to change the culture. When I still see Mr. Hall here and he covered up the abuse of a black child with autism at Adam Elementary School, and you can still have him as an administrator for this school district, that's a slap in the face to me as a black mother. That's a Harry Byrd move. This completely disenfranchised